Baltimore now, the little-known organization that apparently had a big influence on the president's climate decision. CNN senior investigative correspondent Drew Griffin has the lowdown on who they are. He also tried to find out who's financing them. Take a look.
Located in a nondescript office in Washington, D.C., the Competitive Enterprise Institute and its director of energy may have just helped change the political and environmental direction of an entire nation.
And it's been a big win now for you, correct? I mean, this is kind of a coup for your group.
It's a small organization. We have been very persistent. We haven't given up. And I think we have, to a large extent, finally prevailed through the actions of President Trump and his administration.
Myron Ebell has the administration's ear. He ran President Trump's EPA transition team. He supported the president's pick of a climate change skeptic, Scott Pruitt, being chosen as EPA director. And he confirms President Trump's rescinding of six Obama-era executive orders aimed at curbing climate change and regulating carbon emissions was part of his action plan. And from the moment the Paris Accord was signed by the United States, he has worked to persuade the U.S. to get out of it. Just weeks ago, when the White House inner circle was battling over what to do about Paris, CEI put out this TV ad reminding the president what he had promised to do.
We're going to cancel the Paris Climate Agreement and stop all payments of the United States tax dollars to UN global warming programs.
Mr. President, don't listen to the swamp. Keep your promise. Withdraw the U.S. from the Paris Climate Treaty.
That was pressure, right? Were you deliberately trying to remind not the people, not the public, but the president what he said?
Yes. There's a large wing of people who proudly identify as part of the basket of deplorables in the Trump administration. And there are a bunch of people who are much more comfortable identifying as part of the swamp. So there was a debate, a real debate in the White House and in the wider cabinet. So we just wanted to remind the president which side he's on.
Yesterday, the pressure paid off. Myron Ebell and several colleagues at the Competitive Enterprise Institute were at the Rose Garden when President Trump said this.
It is time to exit the Paris Accord.
He claims to have never met President Trump before yesterday, yet his influence over the administration seems undeniable, which scares environmentalists.
The access that Mr. Ebell and the Competitive Enterprise Institute apparently and others who not only don't like the idea of implementing policy to protect us from climate change, but seem to have a thorough scorn for mainstream science was and still is extremely disturbing.
Ebell calls much of the scientific data on global warming questionable. The Institute has been accused of misinterpreting scientific studies and has, according to scientists like Michael Oppenheimer, created a fog of misinformation to confuse voters. Who's paying for all this? That's a good question.
Does the energy industry support you?
Well,
does the coal industry support you?
If you want to know, you'll have to talk to them because under IRS nonprofit law for 501c3s, which we are a nonpartisan, nonprofit public policy institute, we don't disclose our donors.
So, Drew, who does pay? Do we know?
Well, like he said, they don't have to say, and they don't say. I'll tell you this, Anderson, it's mostly large donations from private people. $250,000 up to $1 million in some cases by individuals who are going to remain secret. But we can also tell you that they do have this fundraising dinner, and according to the Washington Post in the past, yes, coal, yes, energy, yes, car companies like Ford, also Google and also Facebook have been involved, but most of the fundraising for this group comes from private people who are remaining private.
All right. Drew Griffin, Drew, thanks very much. Coming up,